So there's this huge gelatinous blob in the ocean that's supposed to be from a squid. How does that work? Let's talk about squid babies, specifically omastrephid squid babies. Omastrephids are sometimes called flying squid because they can fly. They're big, but not giant. Even the biggest omastrephid squid, the Humboldt squid, is usually smaller than a human. Unless you stretch out the tentacles, which is cheating. So how does something this size make something that size? Let's take a look at a female Humboldt squid. She has a body, fins, a head, arms, 8 arms and 2 hidden tentacles, eyes, and a funnel for squirting water to help her swim. On the inside, she has an ovary, 2 oviducts, 2 oviducal glands, and 2 big nidamental glands. Also 3 hearts and a bunch of other stuff that we don't care about now. I'm not going to draw a male squid because they're basically irrelevant except for providing packages of sperm, which the female stores around her mouth in the middle of her arms. When she's ready to lay, her oviducts fill up with ripe eggs. What happens next, no one has ever seen, but we have a good guess. The eggs go through the oviducal glands and get coated with a protective jelly. Then the big nidamental glands make a second kind of jelly, which gets mixed with the eggs and squirted out the funnel. Now the eggs are right next to the sperm so they can get fertilized. And finally, mom lets go of the whole mass. Then the jelly reacts with the seawater and starts to expand. It expands and expands. And eventually we have a gelatinous matrix the size of a car. And it's so dilute at this point that a diver can actually swim through it. The squid's many, many eggs are all suspended within this matrix, spread out from each other so there's no crowding and everyone can breathe. How many eggs are we talking about? Well, the one Humboldt squid egg mass that we've ever seen had somewhere between 500,000 and 2 million eggs in it. All of them from one female? Yeah, we think so. An individual female can have more than 1 million eggs ripe and ready to go in her oviducts. As for the ovary, it can contain millions more unripe eggs, so one mom could make quite a few egg masses. If the ocean is full of egg masses and squid babies, why don't we see them more often? Because the egg masses are transient and transparent, which makes it really unlikely that a diver will stumble across one. And they're too deep underwater to spot from the surface. As for the babies, sure, there are a lot of them, but they're tiny. Each squid baby, when it hatches, is no bigger than a grain of rice. Really cute, though. And most of them do get eaten. For the population to remain stable, the babies face a survival rate of 1/10,000th of a percent. And that's life as a baby squid.